Many Filipino families could have fewer Nochebuena or Christmas Eve dishes this year as soaring prices chip away at their budget, Araya Capulong reports.
And a supermarket shopper checks on the price of each grocery item to make sure it's within the 2,000 peso budget for their Nochebuena and Medianoche. The amount is less than half of the 5,000 pesos she used to spend for her family due to inflation.
Masakit sa ulo, ilang araw ka na pinag-iisipan kasi kung ano talaga yung dapat namin ihanda na dapat kainin lang talaga. Kasi dati, di ba, kung masagana, masagana talaga. Ngayon, budgeted. So, yung pinakamura lang.
With proper budgeting, she was able to buy a half kilo of spaghetti, tomato sauce, macaroni, canned tuna, fruit cocktail, and mayonnaise, which cost a little more than 600 pesos.
Pinapawisan ako. Nagdito, ang hirap mag-budget sa ngayon. Totoo lang, sobra. Hindi katulad ng mga nakaraang taon, Paskuhan. Parang hindi ka na din masaya eh. Gusto mo lang mairaos yung Pasko.
According to the ABS-CBN Investigative Research Group, a budget of 1,301 pesos and 60 centavos, which can buy 11 Nochebuena items for a family of 5 last 2014, can only buy 7 items this year. This is why retailers urge shoppers to be strategic in choosing which items to buy.
Better yung nakaikot sila, may option sila, may mga magpapagpipilian sila na kung alin mas mura. Better yung meron silang listahan para makikita nila kung anong option na gusto nilang item. Kung doon sa walang oras, pwedeng may mga option kami dyan na Christmas basket.
The Department of Trade and Industry meanwhile assures the public it is monitoring the prices of Nochebuena products. Based on its monitoring, 195 out of 223 Nochebuena products have increased prices by 10 to 27%. This include ham, fruit cocktail, mayonnaise, pasta, and spaghetti sauce.
Stable naman po siya. Marami tayong supply rin. We issued the Nochebuena price guide earlier this month. Ito po yung price guide. Ito na yung presyo ng mga produkto na makikita nila sa retail. Yung Nochebuena price guide, that is not regulated by government. Kasi seasonal products to, they're neither basic nor prime. So, ang presyo po, manufacturers ang nagde-decide. Pero nakamonitor kami pagka may biglang tumaas ang presyo compared to the previous prices niya, yung prevailing price. Doon po lang kami na-alert agad.
Raya Capulong, ABS-CBN News.
Now let's now get an update on the situation at the country's main gateway, the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Our very own Vivian Gulia now joins us for that. Viv?
Hi, Carmina. The volume of domestic passengers here at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport this December has actually exceeded pre-pandemic levels amid more relaxed restrictions against COVID-19. The Manila International Airport Authority recorded a total of more than 1.4 million domestic passengers from December 1 until yesterday. This figure is higher compared to the 1.3 million recorded for the same period in 2019, before the Philippines confirmed its first COVID cases. But the number of international passengers at NAIA this December is only at over 988,000, or around 65% of the 2019 figures. In total, the country's main gateway had 2.4 million passengers in the last 3 weeks, and this figure is expected to increase to around 3.5 million as Christmas Day and New Year's Day near. The influx of passengers here at NAIA has been felt since December 16, and yesterday alone, their number reached over 125,000. Here at NAIA Terminal 1, which caters to international flights, the passenger queues are not that long as of this time, and according to some that we talked to, processing was relatively smooth. But in Terminal 3, some passengers had to sit on the floor yesterday while waiting for their flight due to insufficient seats. Inadequate number of push carts also became a problem for some. MIA has already ordered additional push carts. It also reminded airline operators and ground handlers to ensure maximum attendance of personnel and prepare a buffer should more be needed to avoid long lines and at the check-in counters and baggage areas. MIA has removed the initial security screening at the entrances of NAIA. The passenger just needs to present their ticket and ID and get their baggage screened through the security X-ray. MIA assures the public security protocols at NAIA remain in compliance to international aviation standards. Carmina, back to you.